बुद्धोसि बुद्धोसि निरंजनोसि संसार माया परिवर्जितोसि संसार स्वप्नं त्यज्य मोहनिद्रं मदालसोल्लापनुवाच पुत्रम्
इन मथुरा बिकॉज डिवोटीज वर कमिंग कंटिन्यूअसली टू हैव दर्शन ऑफ लॉर्ड कृष्णा देर वर सम बिग ग्रुप ऑफ यवनास वर सिटिंग एट विश्राम घाट एंड हू एवर पीपल वर कमिंग देयर दे आर फोर्सफुली कन्वर्टिंग देम टू मुस्लिम्स सो हियरिंग दैट द प्लेस ऑफ लॉर्ड कृष्णा इज बींग सराउंडेड एंड नॉट एक्सेस वर नॉट गिवन टू डिवोटीज केशव काश्मीरी वेंट विथ 1000 डिसाइपल्स देयर ग्रेट पर्सनालिटी वी नो केशव काश्मीरी इन चैतन्य चरितामृत He is known as Digvijayi Pandit. He was blessed by Saraswati Devi that he could conquer and whatever he speaks is truth by her mercy. And because of it, he was able to go and conquer and everywhere. So, how he came to Navadvipa and how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu handled him. Finally, he came to Navadvipa because this is the best place for education world. He was traveling from every place, conquering all the Pandits in that respective location. All the Shastras were there at the tip of his tongue. So therefore nobody could give a counteraction when he posed a question. So many people could not understand what question he was putting itself. He conquered all the scholars everywhere. When he heard that the capacity of Navadvipa, he came to Navadvipa. All the people in Navadvipa, they became very alerted. Oh, a big Digvijayi has come. So everywhere this discussion only. What is our status? Are we going to conquer him or we are all going to become defeated by him? This information was also passed on to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that a Digvijayi has come, that he is conquered everywhere. He is full of pride and he is like portraying his capacity and personality. He is challenging everyone and anyone. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was laughing and he told his disciples, whenever the Lord sees someone proud of his learning, of his personal quality, he certainly removes the cause of that pride. That is the mercy of the Lord. He would have made a big debate and he would have conquered in front of everyone, then this Digvijayi will lose his face. Not only will lose his face, everybody will start scolding him, laugh at him and make a fun out of him. That you lost unto you conquered the whole world and you are lost in front of a small boy. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very conscious. He didn't want to defeat him in front of everyone. That's why he was thinking, let me isolate him in a certain place so that even if I defeat him, he is not offended. He's thinking, nobody is there to conquer. Nobody is there to compete with me. Pratidvandi. Nobody is there to even counteract with me. So the Digvijayi came to that place where Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was sitting on the bank of Ganges with few disciples. So there was an entire discussion and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked him, he immediately quoted 100 verses on Ganga. Chaitanya Charitamrita says around 48 minutes, he quoted 100 verses. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, all your verses are like a nectar and what you have spoken is correct. They are all beautifully embellished and so many and glorification he had done. But there was one verse Chaitanya Mahaprabhu recited, some 64th verse, and he said, please explain to me. When Keshav Kashmiri could understand that one of the verses which people could not grasp, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had recited and memorized it, and when he explained, he was astonished. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu first said, what is the decorations, what is the alankara, grammar, various things were there, the decorations and all. And finally, he was dumbfounded. He could not speak. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, okay, leave this verse. Quote any other verse. He forgot all the verses, whatever he has spoken. That Digvijayi, who had quoted that 100 verse, he became silent. He was not able to talk. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, I'm a disciple of you. I'm a childish boy. Please do not take my words seriously. Please go today. You are exhausted because 3 hours of recitation, mostly you would have got exhausted. Please go home. Tomorrow morning we will meet and we will further continue the discussion. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu used to handle him so sensitively that the person who is defeated would not feel offended. They were all were very satisfied by the sweet words whomever Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had conquered in Navadvipa. So because everyone got defeated, the Lord did not insult them. Everyone was very pleased with them. Both went to their respective houses. Now, he wanted to know why he got defeated. Whether the boon of Saraswati was a failure or what? Or did he offend Saraswati by any means? So she came in the dream and she explained to him that the person whom he had defeated is the Supreme Lord, personality of Godhead himself. Don't become offended. Don't reveal this knowledge to anyone and everyone. If you reveal, you will die then and there itself. The person whom you had defeated was సుప్రీం లార్డ్, అనంత బ్రహ్మాండ ఈశ్వర, ద లార్డ్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ది యూనివర్సెస్. సో వాట్ ఎవర్ మంత్రాస్ యూ హ్యావ్ చాంటెడ్ ఫర్ మీ, ద రిజల్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద చాంటింగ్ మంత్రాస్ ఈస్ నాట్ దట్ వాట్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఇట్ బికమ్ దిగ్విజయ్. ద రిజల్ట్ ఆఫ్ చాంటింగ్ మై నేమ్ ఈస్ దట్ యూ గాట్ దర్శన్ ఆఫ్ చైతన్య మహా. గౌడ తిరుహట ఢిల్లీ కాశీ ఆదికరి గుజరాత విజయనగర కంచిపురి అంగభంగ తైలాంగ ఓద్ర దేశ ఆరకత పండితేర సమాజ సంసారే ఆచేయత. ఈవెన్ దో ఐఎమ్ సచ్ ఎ స్కాలర్, ఐ వాజ్ స్టిల్ అనేబుల్ టు ఎస్టాబ్లిష్ మై కంక్లూజన్స్ బిఫోర్ యూ. వేర్ డిడ్ ఆల్ మై ఇంటెలిజెన్స్ గో? సో హీ సెయింగ్ ద ఆస్పీషియస్ మూమెంట్ దట్ ఐ హావ్ ఎంటర్డ్ ఇన్ టు నవద్వీప దట్ ఐ వాజ్ ఏబుల్ టు మీట్ యూ అండ్ టాక్ టు యూ. సో ఫైనలీ హీ సేస్ మహాశయ, సో మై హార్ట్ విల్ నాట్ హ్యావ్ ఎనీ ఆఫ్ దిస్ కంటామినేషన్, గివ్ మీ దట్ ఫైనల్ కంక్లూషన్. ఆల్ యువర్ ది ఎసెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ యువర్ నాలెడ్జ్ ఈస్ సరెండర్ టు ద సుప్రీం లార్డ్. Your education should lead him to understand the knowledge and to surrender unto him. Your money will come with you, they will not come with you. As you quit this body, all these things will be left here. So all the people, great great devotees, have renounced all this material world and they have surrendered to the Supreme Lord and they have concentrated upon the Lord. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu hugged him, he became free from all the contaminations and became completely enforced in knowledge. Big group of Yavanas were sitting at Vishram Ghata and whoever people were coming there, they are forcibly converting them to Muslims. So hearing that the place of Lord Krishna is being surrounded and not access were not given to devotees, Keshav Kashmiri went with 1,000 disciples there and he, by the mercy of the Lord, defeated all those Yavanas. And these Yavanas went to their king and informed that Vaishnava has come and he is opposing them. They came with a bigger troop. So Keshav Kashmiri, with the help of the Lord and with all his disciples, threw all these people into river Yamuna and all of them floated and went away to some other place. In that way he protected the place of Lord Krishna so that today we all could go and have darshan of Vrinda. And he wrote one Bhagavad Gita commentary. He became an acharya in Nimbarka Sampradaya. So the mercy what one receives, the conclusions. So he was able to present very nicely. So we should not become, see, sometimes what happens, we read something, we become proud in the process and we disconnected from the subject. So we should be very careful not to become proud. It is the mercy of the Lord, it is mercy of Guru that we, whatever we are able to understand, we should be very happy that they, it is their mercy. And we should be satisfied and we should be able to pass on this knowledge to others. This is the simple principle.
బుద్ధోసి నిరంజనోసి సంసారమాయా పరివర్జితోసి సంసార స్వప్నం త్యజ్య మోహనిద్రం మదాలసోళ్ళ పనువాచ పుత్రం.